2016, and I have to say, you're all looking beautiful from up here this morning, even those I met in the bar last night. So, today, guys, we've got a fantastic programme. We've certainly improved on the seminars for you. And if you feel that, ooh, I'm going to miss that one, whichever I go to, they're all going to be videoed, they're going to be available on the YouTube channel later on this week, so you can see them anyway, which is good. So we've got some great people doing seminars from around the world, some of the old favourites, and we've got some new ones as well. And we've also got Dillis Price. Where's Dillis? Hey! Which I'm really looking forward to, guys. And one thing I found out, Dillis has been in the BPA for 30 years, and this is her first AGM. Before anybody says of it, there is not a beer fine for being a first for the AGM, okay? That doesn't count. So we've got some great people coming, and of course, we've got the exhibitors. We tried to bring you more of that this year as well. So they're there, and there is the opportunity to get one of these. This is the BPA Buff. Now, there's two ways of getting these. One, you can win it in the prize draw tonight, or the team from Argent, who in some hoodies that says Skydive the Mag, you can get them from them. They do cost money, but they are available. Now, one of them did say to you last night, what are these called? Is it a duff? No. Is it a muff? I won't name that person, but the name was Mel. Anyway, so you bump into it, make sure you ask for a buff and not a muff, please. So, what I'd like to do, I have a bit of a QVC moment just to demonstrate how this works. And I've found a lovely assistant already, please, Louise. So I'd just like to show you. Oh, please, yeah. A round of applause to Louise on my QVC moment. So, this is like QVC, yeah, turn around. It fits this way. You can wear it this way. See, there you go. This is multi-purpose. This was designed by Craig, of the head of the development committee, and your vice chair. So there we go. So, how was that, Louise?
Fantastic response.
As always. Absolutely. Thank you very much. Round of applause, Louise. Today's events, as we said, we've got a prize draw this evening. Do not miss it. We've had 595 people register, which is a record, so thank you very much for doing that. We hope to see you back in the theatre at 5 o'clock, as always. So, to be at 5 o'clock. This evening, we've got some great entertainment post the dinner, which everybody is invited to. We've got a great comedian called John Robinson, who's from Australia, but he's come from London to see us. We've got a band called Dive Exit, which I think many of you know, from Langer. And then we've got the DJ till 2 o'clock. So, a really exciting day. What I'd like to do is give a big thank you to our sponsors, which is Romero, Liberty and Archon, who've contributed to the day. So thank you, round of applause to them, please. So what I need to do now, guys, there's a bit of housekeeping, the normal thing, so I have to read this out to you because it's health and safety. So a quick word about emergency evacuation. Don't run, it's not yet, it's not real. There is no fire alarm plan today, so please don't run. So if it does sound, it's for real, because it's never planned. The fire alarm is a continuous, single, and annoying tone siren. Make mind up on that one, I'm sure you'll be aware of it. If the alarm sounds, leave the building by the nearest fire exit and congregate in the bottom car park there. The assembly points out, in the event of a fire emergency, a member of the centre staff will help you. But if you can't find one of them and there isn't an emergency, then dial 8888, not 999 as it says on here. So, whatever happens. So, if you can't find anybody, that's the situation. So, without further ado, we move on to the formal part of the day, which is the AGM, and the most interesting, absolutely. And I'm going to bring you on chair of the Stage Council. So, with a less than formal intro from myself, here is Martin Salisbury. Roll the video, guys. Martin Salisbury.
Thank you very much. Can anyone hear me?
Oh, good.
Thank you very much. Welcome everyone to Nottingham. for the 2016 AGM and the review of 2015. We'll just wait for a few people to hurry their way in. Come in, come in. Don't look. Shut the doors. Plenty of seats at the back. Be brilliant. I'm very sorry to say that in 2015 we had two fatalities. In July, Chris Jones, and in September, Ali Woodford. I would like to take a minute to remember both of them and the following members passed away since the last AGM. Tony Collins, Graham Godding, Brian Greenwood, Joseph Hepburn, Lynn Johnson, Chris Jones, Pauline McKay, Adrian Mills, Andrew Parry, Ian Pashmore, Justin Roberts, Barry Robinson, Lofty Thomas, Pat Walters, Andy Wildmore, and Ali Woodford. Can I ask you to join me and stand for a minute's silence? Thank you. For those of you who've been coming for many years, you know we've been kind of tweaking the way we do the AGM. And this year we've gone a few stages further. Hopefully it means my speech will be a bit shorter, by about 2 minutes, don't you? And more fun. What we've done is we produce an annual report, which is in the bundle of papers. And it's quite a big bundle, and that's to give you something to read when you get bored during Craig's presentation. In there is the annual report. We published it a week earlier, it was on the website, and it's also in that bundle there, and we'll be putting it out with the mag. And in that annual report we have, for the first time, reports from all major chairs of committees, and also key members of staff. And we'll be taking questions on that item 4 on the agenda if anyone has any questions on either my speech or the annual report. That frees me up to give you the fun highlights of 2015, some of the plans we have for 2016. As I said, maybe make it a little bit shorter. I'd like to start by thanking people. I'd like to thank all the drop zones, all the staff of those drop zones, CIs, chief pilots, pilots, riggers, instructors, who've all been involved in hosting competitions, coaching road shows, and instructor courses. I'd like to thank the judges and the examiners and advanced instructors who work on those courses and the competitions as well. I'd specifically like to thank this ugly group. You know they're ordered in best looking to worst looking. I think they got the order wrong though. They put me first. So, it's the 2015 Council. We've been working very hard last year in preparing for quite a lot of change that we have planned for 2016. Obviously, the special resolution is one of those major changes. I'll speak a little bit about that later. I'd also like to thank the staff, BPA, especially Martin Shuttleworth, Tony Butler, and Jeff Montgomery, who keep me instructing now. I'd also like to thank these individuals as well. The BPA is run for and by its members. A lot of individuals who volunteer their time freely give a huge amount of time to the BPA. These individuals selflessly give a lot to the BPA and they make us the association we are. Thank you very much. 5 years ago, when I became chair, we put together a set of strategic goals. And, you know, that's been the focus of what we've been trying to do for the last few years. So they are, as always, safety first. And I'll talk a little bit later about that, but, you know, we have a safety record that's the envy of the world. Pursuing excellence, that's not just in competition, but in everything we do. And that's part of the governance review we're doing. Retaining members, and by that we mean full members, year on year. And the premises refurbishment. We as jumpers, you know, we want the best and safest we can be. And this extends the idea of our association. So we have been looking at the governance of the association. We've been speaking about this now for a couple of years. And for a couple of years now. And later on this morning we'll have a special resolution which will talk about the changes. So how have we got there? Back in 2014, we as in council, commissioned a report from a lady called Amanda Bennett, who's an expert in governance in sporting bodies. She made a number of recommendations, having looked at our governance, which basically hasn't changed since the 1960s. We set up a working group, Special Futures Working Group, to actually look at how those changes could be fitted into the BPA, what were around, what were not relevant, and how we would do it. In 2015, we went out to membership, to you guys, to consult, and that was via magazine articles, UKS, Facebook, and the BPA website, plus a couple of roadshows we did. That feedback from the membership was taken on board, some changes made, and then council had the new articles drawn up, and that's part of what you have in your bundle today. So on the back of the agenda, we have the new articles we're proposing. So what are those changes? They are to reduce the size of council from the current 15 down to 12. Across industry and other sporting bodies, the perceived wisdom is that actually, to be an efficient body, you need to be between 10 and 12 as a board. So we've gone to slightly the top end of that, mainly because the people on council work and not the other committees below. We have, of those 12, 10 will be directly elected, as we normally do. Two of them, though, will be independents. Again, cross industry, that's referred to as non-executive directors. In fact, all your councils are non-executive because they're not actually employed by the BPA. So these are independent. By independent, we mean individuals who have no business or family ties to skydiving. And the idea is they'll be tasked with actually doing what's the best for the association. Now, I know some people have concerns about this because, well, hang on a second, they're going to vote. They're not skydivers, what will they know? No, but they'll be experts in good governance. They'll be experts in finance or experts in marketing, and they'll bring that to the meetings. We have lots of experts in skydiving in our committees and on council. They're going to bring other skills to the party. The other thing we're going to do is increase the tenure on council from 1 year to 3 years. Often heard phrase is that, you know, when you join council, it takes you a number of years to get up to speed, to understand how the processes work, and also to kind of buy into what we're doing. Also, if you're already on council, your 1 year election cycle tends to mean that you tend to think quite short term. Okay, what am I going to achieve this year? We want people to be starting to think about long term strategy. That's what you as members want from your council. But we will limit the period you can be on council for 3 terms, so a maximum of 9 years. Then you would have to stand down for 3 years for a term before you could reapply or be re-elected. And the idea behind that is we don't want your council to become institutionalised.
to have said, well, we tried that 15 years ago and it didn't work, it won't work now, type of conversations that we sometimes hear. And we want people coming on with new, fresh ideas to challenge the perceptions we have. Now, one of the things we don't want is all 12 seats to come up for reappointment at the same time, so we're going to stagger them. And in the articles, there's some sections in italics. Those are the transitionary process, how we build the stagger in. So we only have 4 seats come up for reappointment every year. Once we've gone through 3 years and we've got the stagger built in, we'll then actually have another vote here at an AGM and we'll remove those italic sections. Now, I've given you lots of reasons why we're doing that. In reality, the main reason is because you, as our members, us as an association, our partners, business partners, and also our key stakeholders, deserve the best leadership we can provide. Professional, inspirational, long-term strategic thinking. So I hope later, agenda item 6, when we come to special resolution, you will vote to pass it. Obviously, if anyone has any questions on the resolution, when we get to agenda item 6, that's when you can ask them. Okay? So, the next strategic goal is actually retaining members. So how did we do? So for the membership year, which ended March 2015, we saw a 5% increase in full members to 6,269. And we also saw a record number, we saw a record number of students, 59,863. Now, unfortunately, as we all know, summer wasn't that great, 2015. So that kind of affects some of the numbers we have here. But in terms of retaining full members, again, 5% year-on-year increase. These are people who were members in 2014 and renewed in 2015, which is great. And that's down to, well, I'll claim credit for it, actually that's down to you as members, the instructors, the drop zones out there, they've done fantastic work. Which is good, you're doing a great job. Let's keep doing it. But there's something else, you know, we want more. And I want to talk to you about sex. Careful, careful. I'm not talking about the 2 a.m. tonight type of sex you're thinking about. Stop thinking about it. Right. First timers, basically a 50-50 split, female male. However, our full members are only 17% female. When it comes to instructors, even less. However, if you look at our competitions team, nearly 40% of our female competitors are female. So why is that? Is that because we have strong role models in competition? You know, I challenge you, I challenge our council, challenge our committees to think about sex. How can we retain and attract more females into scuba diving? Now, I have a simple set of images here to help you remember what is the right sex to think about here. As Adrian was talking about, one of our themes today is we're pushing the BPA buffs. So we have Tony in a buff. That's safe sex. That's the type of sex we should be talking about, all right? Now, I apologise anyone with a hangover here, any young children. We also have Tony in the buff. So, number of students trained in 2015. As you see, I believe the weather affected that. So 2014 was a record year. It was just shy of 60,000 trained in 2015. However, in terms of A licences issued, as you can see, another record year. Jump numbers, again, I say affected by the weather. 271,507. Fantastic year in 2014, our second best ever year, 2015. So, remember, sex. The final part of our strategy was around property refurbishment. And we've been looking at is Bouquet Towers. This is a building we've owned for just over 25 years. It's a freehold. It was built, I think, as a builder's merchant. And it has a flat, or it used to have a flat upstairs with a full bathroom, which we still have. You know, the stairwell, it's not used. There'd been no major investment in the building for the time we've owned it. So back 5 years ago, I asked the question, is this building fit for purpose for us as an association? And the answer came back resoundingly from the staff and members of the association, no. So we've been looking at what we can do over the last 4 years. We've looked at selling it and buying something new and fitting it out. We've looked at selling it and renting. We've looked at selling it and relocating with another sister organisation in the model of Hall Gliders. Basically, your council decided that none of those would be financially viable or good for the association long term in terms of this largest asset that we have. So we decided what we'd do is actually refurbish. I'm very pleased to say that last year, after a number of false starts, we actually found an architect's set of drawings that both the staff and the association feel are right for us. So we'll be going to tender relatively soon, and hopefully in 2016 we'll be refurbishing the building. Now normally, about now, I'll be talking about Europe and how EASA has invented some new rule to kind of bugger us up. This year it was actually CAA that threw us the curveball. But before I talk about that, I'd like to apologise. When I stand up here and do these speeches, I kind of talk about safety, and safety first, and I'll be really good at safety, and then move on. I did it earlier this morning. And I'm kind of a bit glib about it. And when I turn around and people say, oh, we've got the best safety record in the world, people look at me and go, yeah, you would say that, wouldn't you? Here are some numbers from IPC, and they're from 2013, the last 4 years, and it's fatalities to jump numbers. And as you can see, the UK is the safest place to do a skydive. Now, fortunately, we don't have a huge number of skydiving fatalities around the world, so it only needs one or two to change, and those must change. But what I can say is, for a member of the general public, the UK is the safest place to do a tandem in the world, and has been for a long, long time. So anyway, CAA. CAA were tasked by the last coalition government to cut down in red tape. And they went to that task with relish. One of the things they were talking about was deregulating sports aviation. And it specifically comes to parachuting, they were talking about taking us out of the air navigation order. So it effectively totally deregulated us as a sport. Now the positives, we pay just a shade under £29,000 to the CAA to self-regulate ourselves. So we get that money back in theory. However, quite quickly, you can go to the conclusion, hang on a second, that means anybody could open a parachute centre. Anybody could take someone for a tandem skydive without any form of training, without any form of regulation, without any form of, you know, safety. So, as you'd expect, council thought this was a bad idea. And we made our views known to the CAA. And we explained what we thought the implications of deregulating skydiving. And the CAA was surprised. That gave them pause for thought. And they had to kind of start changing their ideas. Now, following the unfortunate accident in Shoreham, the air show, the whole process has been put on hold because one of the other areas they were looking to deregulate was air shows. Now, we think we've changed the CAA's mind. Obviously, when the air accident report comes out, we'll see how they want to progress. But on behalf of you as members, we will be fighting deregulation, making our views known. Talking about safety, obviously STC is our main technical committee that looks after safety. And I'd like to congratulate STC on their hard work. John Hitchin is chair of STC. I would always support STC to the highest level. The simple reason I think CIs who sit on STC have the hardest job. They have to balance our safety, allow us to safely get out of aeroplanes, skydive and land, but also actually deal with whole new exciting areas that we're developing. You know, challenges that we're giving to them as we try new things all the time.
So I think you're a fantastic record. They have a fantastic safety record. Also, I'd like to thank Jeff Montgomery, who had his own personal record, that in 2015 we had a record number of instructor courses. We ran 46 instructor courses with 153 either new instructors or instructors getting new ratings. The Royal Aero Club is the governing body of all aero sports in the UK. And every year they have annual awards. This year it's going to be, I think, 18th of May, and in central London. And we get to put forward nominations. And for individuals we believe need recognition in the larger aviation community. And I'm very pleased to say that all our nominations were successful this year, and they were recently announced. Some individuals know, some don't. We got silver medal for Mikey Lovemore. Mikey Lovemore had a fantastic year in 2015. At the Nationals, Speed Skydiving Nationals in August, he broke the 12-year-old speed record, going on to win. Then in September, he went to the World Cup and European Championships, where he broke his own record twice, went faster than 500 kilometers per hour, becoming the fifth person through that competition, the fourth fastest person in the world, and he won the silver medal. He's been awarded the Passport Skydiver of the Year for 2015. Above all of that, Mikey's passionate about speed skydiving. He's been a discipline rep for many, many years, and there isn't a single person in speed skydiving that hasn't been touched by his enthusiasm, professionalism, and expertise. So congratulations, Mikey. We also have a silver medal. You could applaud if you like. I apologise if I'm rattling through this, but Adrian stole all my time. We've got silver medal for Dougie Peacock. For those who haven't read his book, I highly recommend it. Dougie's been skydiving for 59 years, starting in 1956, which, before anyone says it, was before I was born. He's a founding member of the BPA. He's spent most of his life skydiving, working in skydiving, whether for the RAF, for the BPA, or overseas in Oman. However, he still skydives. He is currently an advanced instructor and also an FAA international and nationally rated judge. Again, someone well deserving a medal who has given a huge amount to skydiving internationally. Congratulations, Doug. Bronze medal for Paul Applegate. Apples has been on council for 19 years and chair of riggers for nearly 20 years. His contribution to rigging, again, nationally and internationally, is huge. So, Apples, congratulations on your bronze medal. We have a bronze medal for Jackie Harper. In January 2015, Jackie with the IPC was instrumental in getting wingsuiting adopted as a discipline. At the same meeting, she went on bid and won to host the first ever wingsuiting World Cup. That was the first category event in skydiving ever to be held in the UK. She went on to host that very successful competition, raising the profile of British wingsuiting and skydiving in the UK internationally. But not only content to actually host the event, she competed. She had three female records and one world record. So congratulations, Jackie, for winning. So Adrian, the little video at the beginning was a surprise to me. I didn't know that was coming. So Adrian, add it back. Certificate of Merit. Adrian Bond is Chair of Communications, has been for a number of years, but what he's done that's different, I feel, he actually brings, would you believe it, professionalism and a commercial experience to the way we do procurement, with the way we deal, the BPA deals with commercial partners. Lots of examples, but I'll give you just a couple. There's Skydive the Mag, we've gone from costing each member annually £17 to £5. He's responsible for Skydive the Expo, as he said himself. More presentations, massive gala dinner, more prizes at the draw, more exhibitors outside. Also, I think this is worth the certificate alone. Drink price is £2.75 for a pint. John Krosnowski. And the majority of you will go, who? Never heard of him. That's maybe a good thing. John isn't a member of the BPA, he's in Skydive. He's a solicitor. And he's actually, effectively, our solicitor. Since the late 90s, he's been working on behalf of the BPA, or half the BPA's insurers, as our solicitor to defend cases. And he, well, effectively, when we change insurers, we insist that they use John, as he's an aviation expert and very successful in defending cases on behalf of the BPA. Now, that's not really worth a certificate alone, because that's his day job, so he gets paid for. But what he's done over and above is that actually he puts a huge much back into us as an association. He feeds his knowledge back into the CIs, the drop zone operators, to our safety management systems, which allow us to operate very safely. Insurers love it, we get lower premiums. He also is hugely influential in things like reviewing the medical form. So his input to that, all free, is fantastic. He also, where appropriate, offers other legal advice to us free, which has been totally invaluable. So thank you very much for all your work, John. And last, we have Martin Mansley, Certificate of Appreciation. And Martin is actually our insurance broker with Romero. And we describe him as innovative. And by that, we're talking about in previous years, we've had insurance brokers who turn up and go, yes, thank you very much. Here's the price of insurance, thank you. Martin actually says, how can I help? What can we do different? Examples of some of the changes he's brought about is £15,000 cash payouts if a member is seriously injured or dies. Unfortunately, a number of members have taken advantage of that. He raised the maximum payout from £2 million to £5 million, giving our drop zones a lot better cover if they were to be sued. But really, the key thing he's done, he moved us from an aviation insurer to a sports insurer, which means over 6 years we've been working with Martin, he saved all of us over £2 million. So thank you very much, Martin. Talking about the Royal Aero Club, there's a Royal Aero Club Trust. This offers bursaries, and they've extended the age limit from 16 to 24. I still fall just outside it. But this is effectively free money. So anyone in those age groups, I highly recommend that you go onto either the BPA website, where there's a link, or the Royal Aero Club Trust, where there's a link, download the forms, and get your CI or a member of the BPA staff to sign them, and this gives you money towards getting stickers. It's free money to Skydive. Why wouldn't you do it? What I'd also like to talk about now is a little bit more of some of the work that the committees have done. So we have development. They've been working on a tender for a new membership database, personal information management system, PIMS. I think they were drinking. That will totally change, I'll use the word radically change, but it will change the way that you interact with the BPA. And we're looking that to go out to tender middle of this year. They also engaged with a development consultant, Simon Kirkland, to produce a report on how to develop the sport. So he's produced the first draft of that, and we're really focusing on elite coaching and actually changes to instructor courses. But we're looking at, again, we'll take ideas from the floor on how we can actually develop as a sport. They're also responsible for membership insurance, which I'll be talking about at the end. and they're responsible for the BPA Star Awards, which Craig will be announcing during the awards ceremony. We have communications, which Adrian chairs, which has been raising the profile of the sport through a PR campaign, using the network of magazines run by Archon. The expo, so more exhibitors, more speakers, more prizes. And don't forget to be in the prize draw here. You have to be here to win it, even if your name's in the pot. You need to actually physically come and claim the prizes. And that's at 5 o'clock this afternoon here. They've also commenced a tender process on a new family of BPA websites, which will tie in with the membership database. And they've also delivered a communication strategy document. So, as you see, a lot of stuff that happened in 2016 in these committees. And finally, competitions, chaired by Brian Basher, who unfortunately couldn't be here today. Responsible delegations for international competitions, domestic competitions, coaching roadshows. And also they spent a lot of 2015 restructuring the allocation criteria for funding of teams and individuals to make it more transparent, objective, and also to cover as many disciplines as possible. So, that really is what your council, your committees, have been doing in 2015, some of the plans we have for 2016. Now is an opportunity for us to have a look at what you guys have been doing. So I think you say the words, run the video. in danger pants. Hopefully he's tried them out now. Anyway, in 2015 there were no major world championships, but there were lots of other international competitions. As I already mentioned, we had the first ever, first category event, FCE, ever to be held in skydiving in the UK, which was at Netherhaven, very successful. Even more successful because Spike won a silver medal. And at the end of the competition, Spike and Jackie went on to set two new world records in distance and in time. We had CP World Cup and European Championships in Canada, which is the hub where the World Championships this year are going to be held. And we had our first ever medal in FCE, with Wes Wesley winning a silver medal in the European Championships for speed. Congratulations there, Wes. We had a World Cup in Toyota, the FS Artistics and Speed, and that was also European Championships. Again, more medals. We had Mikey winning silver, as I already mentioned, and Euphoria Free Fly getting bronze. We had indoor champion world, the first ever indoor skydiving world championships. Now, I have to say, when I looked at this picture, I couldn't help but think of those two ladies on the right, who most of you will know. All I could think of was Cougar. That sex coming up again, I don't know what's going on there. But, very successful. Flying Like a Girl won bronze in the female four-way. And Flow Well, Dynamic Two-Way. That's a very new up-and-coming set of young gentlemen we keep an eye on. And we had the World Air Games in Dubai, which featured quite a lot in the video. And I think the people editing the video like the background that's got out of Dubai. And again, very successful. Mikey Lovemore and Euphoria winning bronze medals. So, very successful international year for us. Nationals. Always great to talk about how we're getting more disciplines, more nationals, more participants. And this year is no different. We had the FS Artistic and Speed Nationals held at Hibblestow. And Hibblestow back to its best, the machine that is Hibblestow. The eight-way and artistics were completed in one day, 10 rounds of eight-way. Now, in the past, last year, I was criticised for making fun of the USPA and the size and number of teams that they had at their FS four-way nationals. And in this new PC environment that we've survived in, that apparently I caused upset and offence. And in a very, I sound like Jeremy Clarkson now, aren't I? I didn't mean to, obviously. I was, you know, the USPA are 10 times the size we are. You know, why should I make fun of them only having 60 teams at 2015 USPA Nationals in four-way? Very successful. The previous year they had 56, so they went up to 60. So congratulations, they've been good. Unfortunately, in 2014, we had a record number of teams at our British four-way FS Nationals, which was 75. In 2015, we had less. I don't want to cause offence, so I won't mention how many teams we had. What I will say, it was more than 60. It was more than 65. It was more than 69, but less than 71. we had the accuracy at Swansea, and really great to see new competitors in accuracy. It's a sport that's been, and I don't think the competitors will mind me saying this, stalling for a little while. New people, no, it wasn't a pun. But there's new blood in the sport, which is fantastic to see, and congratulations Carl for driving that. We had CP and VFS four-way nationals at Dunk as well, and Wingsuit at Netherhaven. Again, where more national and international records were set. We had CF at Black Knights, and we had Speed 8 Nationals at Sibson. So again, huge number of drop zones being involved in our nationals. So thank you to all of those. But it's not just about competitions. We also be involved in setting national and international records. We had the women's 11-way head-down record set in Sibson in July. We had an 64-way head-down world record with a large UK contingent. There we go. We had a new Head Down record sets in the UK. I don't need to do any of the other stuff earlier, I just need to show these pictures and walk off, don't I really? And 202-way FS sequential record set in Paris. Again, very nice. Earlier in my speech, I talked about Martin Mansley from Romero, an insurance broker, and also we have Liberty Mutual, who are our insurers. And that relationship we've been working on for many, many years, and it's a very good, strong relationship. And as Adrian said, you know, earlier, they're sponsors of events during the day and this evening. They give money for a safety fund. They also put up an award, which my young assistant here will pass to me, the Safety Innovation Award, which, Mr. Fletcher has done Mr. Fletcher, the award builder for national and international events. They put up a cash prize for the best safety innovation in skydiving. And it seemed no one really wanted to, you know, brag about the safety things they did. So for 2016, come on, drop zones, these heads, teams. You know, if you've done change your processes, brought out some new safety innovation, please come forward and win that trophy. Back in November last year, came as a bit of a surprise to me, maybe so to other people, the government increased the tax on insurance premiums from 6.5% to 9%. Now, Romero and Liberty very kindly absorbed that cost increase for this membership year. And for the next membership year, 16-17, they're actually going to reduce our insurance element by 3%. Council in December took a vote, and because of the strong financial position the association is in and the increasing membership numbers we have, subject to your approval later on in this AGM, they would suggest that we reduce the BP element by 3% as well. That would mean a fall in next year's membership, full membership, of £3.12. I always measure it as a challenge. Challenge maybe to Adrian. That you can buy a pint at the AGM and still have change left, not reductionists. I don't know what you do with that change, but there you go. So that would mean that full membership in 16 years, 17, as long as you pass it later on this AGM, will be £102.80. And as you see, over the last number of years, that's fallen. And again, that's all down to the hard work of our drop zones, safety management systems, the BPA team, Tony, Jeff, John Hitchens, Chair of SDC, and obviously our insurers and our insurance brokers. So thank you very much. Gathered by the speech, really, I feel 2015 was your council doing a lot of groundwork, committees, on massive changes that we want to put in place in 2016. Not just the governance, but, you know, we're looking to make major changes. So what, in summation, what have we done? We have the governance changes, which we'll be voting on the resolution later on. We've tendered for the new family of BPA websites and the membership database. We have a tender for the refurbishment of the BPA towers. We have a 3% reduction in membership. We have a record number of students, jump numbers, membership. We have a very healthy financial position. Now, I want to wish you a great day today. Here, have fun buying things next door, going to the presentations. For those coming to the gala dinner, it'll be a fantastic event. But BPA mantra, safety first. I want to think, when you think at 2 a.m. tonight, not about sex, I want you to think about, do I need another drink? Bit of a tradition now, I'll start taking pictures Sunday morning at breakfast. Joel did not need another drink at 2 a.m. So please, enjoy your day, have a fun and safe 2016. What I'd like to do now is, we've got quite a lot on the agenda to get through. So, it's interesting, really. It is. We quickly kind of nipped through the admin of it. We've got apologies for absence from Brian Vasher and Gavin McLeod. Oh, I need to look at that, you know. Item three, the minutes from last year's AGM. Can I have someone to nominate and accept them? Thank you very much. Have someone to second that? Thank you very much. Anyone against accepting the minutes? Abstentions? Thank you, passed. Okay, item four, to receive and adopt the annual report. What I'd like to do stage, if anyone has any questions on the annual report, the printed version you have there, or my speech. And also it would help if you could actually refer to the page number your queries on. Does that have anyone have any questions on the annual report? Thank you. In our quest to be modern, actually you can download this next year. Or we're like some feedback. We're actually tempted not to give printed copies on the seats, which obviously cost us, and actually say to people, you can download it off the website, which obviously you can do now. So feedback to us not now. Feedback to us your thoughts on that. Okay. So, I'd like to have someone nominate accepting the annual report. Are you waving to someone?
No, I was waving to somebody else.
Just waving to someone. Pay attention, I'm going to report something. Okay. Can someone please propose we accept the annual report? Thank you very much. Someone second that? Thank you. Anyone against accepting the annual report? Any abstentions? Thank you very much. Unanimous. I now hand over to Madam Treasurer.
Good morning, everyone. Martin's already told you everything, so there seems little point in me repeating it. But we are looking for a 3% reduction in the BPA element, which means with the confirmed insurance amount, you will be paying £102.80 for the coming year. So could I please have a proposer and a seconder? Thank you very much. Anyone against that? May I say it's been approved unanimously. Thank you very much.
Okay, agenda item six, a special resolution to change the Articles of Association. And again, on the back of the agenda, the new articles, which I'm sure you've all read and digested in huge detail. Now this is a special resolution, which means we need a 75% majority for it to pass. So does anyone have any questions on the changes we're talking about, changes to the articles? Yeah? It's for being a member of council. Yeah. Did anyone hear the questions raised? No. The question was, in terms of three times 3 year terms, 9 years, then there has to be a stand down for a 3 year term. Was that for just the position I held or for all positions? Effectively, all we're talking about here is council. By being on council, you're a director of BPA Limited, and you obviously have fiduciary issues, but therefore, you stand for 9 years, if you're elected 3 times, and then you have to stand down from council as a director of BPA for a 3-year term. Okay? Any other questions? Yes, Mr. Marshall.
It doesn't stop you getting co-opted on the council.
The only position to be co-opted on the council would be as a treasurer or as a chair of STC, but you'd be a non-voting member of council, and you wouldn't be a director of BPA Limited. Any other questions? Yep.
Is the 3 times 3 years retrospective, or does it start now? So if somebody's been on for 5 years, then it could be about 9.
Yes, is a short answer. It actually starts from next year, if it's passed, it'll start from next year's election, 2017 election. So yes, we'll start then. Yeah, I mean, we've got people, I mentioned Apples has been on council for 19 years. It's a difficult thing, because, I mean, you know, you look at someone like Apples, not too closely, I hope, and, you know, he brings a wealth of experience and knowledge, historical knowledge, you know, of what we have done in the past. And that doesn't necessarily mean, you know, oh, we tried that, it didn't work, but actually we did that, and this was the implication of it, this is where it went wrong. So that's a useful skill to have. There is a danger that we do lose that, but we believe we'll gain more by actually allowing people to step down and encouraging new ideas when we go on to council. Okay, any other questions? I can't see very well with the lights. That's why. Yeah. Oh, sorry, I should have said that in my speech and I apologise. So we'll have a nominations committee, and that nomination committee will recommend to you as an AGM the individuals, and you will approve them. So you will actually vote for them to be on council. Any other questions? It's good, this. I've given comments. No? You're just twitching up there, aren't you? Rubbing your ear. Okay, just checking. Are we ready to go to a vote on this? Yeah? Oh. Yes, sorry. So it's a similar answer to the gentleman's question earlier, which is you have a clean slate. The clock starts, if you like, in 2017.
So in 9 years,
in 2026, good, that's good. Have
everyone
living
at the same time?
No, sorry, I apologise. So I spoke about my speech, the fact we're introducing a stagger.
Okay.
Yeah? So you'll have... we think there will be, I don't want to use the term natural wastage because some people are a certain age on council, but love you, Ian, love the work you're doing. We will be staggering, so there will be people who will only be on council initially for 1 year, and then 2 years, and 3 years, so we'll introduce a stagger. So we will. Good, very good question. And the answer is that we will actually use the 2017 election as an ordering. So popularity vote, you will order. So that the out of 10 elected members, the three lowest, will be only standing for 1 year. The next up in the order will be for 2 years, and then the top ones for 3 years. And that's how we introduce the stagger. And the independents will initially be for 1 year and for 2 years, so they fall in sync with that. And before I'm going to ask it, if we have, as this year we have no contested election, so we just have 10 or less people stand, it will be done drawing lots. Okay? Anything else? Good. Are we ready to go to a vote? Yeah, cool. So I would like to ask for a proposer and seconder this special resolution. Thank you very much. All those against? Abstentions? Just for a bit of fun. All those in favour? I declare that passed. Thank you very much. Agenda item 7 was to declare the results of the membership election. Well, unfortunately we didn't have one. Only 15 individuals stood for council, so they all got on. Honestly, I've almost finished. Really? Okay, and the last item on the agenda is to formally close the proceedings. So, thank you very much for your time. I now hand you over to Craig, who will be doing the award ceremony and presentations. Thank you very much.
Martin, as he said, moving on to the awards. Martin's stolen everybody's thunder this morning. That's good news for us today. Firstly, as always, Tazacorta Trophy for experienced skydiver of the year. I'm very pleased this year to say that Taz's mum, Hazel, and her sister Gail are here to be able to present the award. I'd like to invite them up on the stage, please.
Means a lot to us, and there was just a couple of things I wanted to say. First of all, as you may know, excuse me, I'm really nervous. As you may know, the BPA don't give this award every year, and I think that's absolutely right because it only ever goes to somebody who is really exceptional. The other thing I wanted to say is that I really didn't know a lot about speed skydiving. I read the citation, it sounded amazing. Somebody dashing through the air at over 300 miles an hour. And I kind of realised that's the sort of thing that Taz actually would have absolutely loved. And the other thing it made me realise was that this citation and this award goes to a truly exceptional person who has achieved something very unique during the last year. And as you probably know, it goes to Mikey Lovemore.
We've got the photographer and the great BPA background where we have all the photos taken. Thank you. Moving on to Instructor of the Year Trophy for 2015. The Chief Operating Officer and Safety Training Officer choose the Instructor of the Year, and it is awarded to someone who has gained their rating within the past 12 months. The criteria used is that the instructor not only did very well on the course, but is also the type that students would be very happy to turn to for advice. For Instructor of the Year 2015, the COO and SDO have chosen from Hibblestow, Andy Poynter. Skydiver of the Year. Chief or Advanced Instructors nominate the new Skydiver of the Year. The criteria used is that a relatively new skydiver is nominated who has progressed well during the last year and is also considered to be a valuable member of their club. This is the citation we received. The nominee for the Mike Forge Trophy has been put forward not just because of his own parachute achievements, but also for his considered and dogged attitude to his progression, even at his early stage, a willingness to assist others. Since his first static line descent in June 2015, the nominee has logged 80 descents and has demonstrated considerable tenacity in developing his talent. He enjoyed four first freefall descents, but only after saving six dummy pulls and relishing eight static line descents. He is now a B-licensed parachutist and has bought his own parachute system. But typical of his approach, he has listened to guidance on downsizing and took advice on all the components. Though he works hard to develop his own skill set, he has already voiced his intent to qualify as an instructor. He has already qualified for packing checks and competent in delivering seminars about the category system and history of parachuting to ab initio students. He willingly forgoes the opportunity to jump if it means packing for a student to enable them to meet the weather window, get ahead of the weather window. This approach has a tangible and positive effect on the job. The recipient of the BPA New Skydiver of the Year for 2015 from JSPC Netherhaven is George Wasson. Examples of fantastic service within our sports, and we believe they should be recognised. That's why the association asked A-licence holders and above to tell us about great service they received from another BPA member, to tell us they spotted a BPA star. Each eligible nomination has been considered by a panel of judges, and those judges are the five BPA vice presidents, and thank you to them for their time for doing this. We have three winners for BPA Star Awards this year. 2015, they are Andy Guest from Skydive Buzz Dunkerswell, Chris Shaw from UK Parachuting Simpson, and Marianne Stevens from London Parachute School. International judges certificates are awarded to the following judges who qualified in 2015. We have three: Frank Malabone for wingsuiting, David McMinn for wingsuiting and speed skydiving, and Joel Strickland for artistics.
Thank you.
whole raft of these. Those qualified in 2015 are as follows. Bob Charters for wingsuit, Ruth Cooper for wingsuit, Richard Del Toro for FS8 speed, Tasha Higman for formation skydiving, Adam Maticola for artistics, Claire Moncaster for formation skydiving, Don Tomkinson for canopy piloting and canopy formation, and Georgina Worth for canopy piloting.
You're unbelievable!
Jump Freefall Certificates. Certificate this year is awarded for 5,000 jumps and 72 hours of freefall to the BPA's medical advisor, Dr. John Carter. Now for some medals. 2015 Grand Prix UKSL overall medalists. Firstly, accuracy landings, and senior event overall accuracy landing champion is Pete Sizer. Four-way rotations, quite fun. And senior event overall champions, gold medal is Team Mysterons, Jason Hobbs, Paul Noah, Derek O'Neill, Gareth Hughes, and Matt Kite. Congratulations, Jason. Give us a wave, Jason. He's just come back from Florida where he just achieved a sequential world record in CF. Is that right, Jason?
Yeah.
25-foot diamond. Next, canopy piloting. Intermediate event overall champion goes to Scott McKenzie. Senior overall champion is Dan Guest. Okay, moving on to formation skydiving. We're going to bring up all three teams for each class in this one. So for rookie in four-way, bronze medalists are Team Fantastic Four, Vincent Adams, Kim Filchens, Claire Humphreys, Stephen Campbell, Peter Hodges. Silver medalists are Team AAC Blue Eagles, Andrew Reed, Ryan Beattie, Daniel Wright, Dick Kimber, Josh Clark, Jamie Hart. James Lowry, and Oval Champions for gold medal is Team Blue Steel. Seamus Yemisenka, wait for it. Claire Jones, James Parry, Joshua Bryan, Ian Rayner, and Raphael Barbier Saint-Hilaire. Team AGC Blue, Laura Wilsby, Marcus Lindsay Smith, MBE, Jessica French, Sean Saxford, Colin Jenkins, Spencer Bailey. Silver medalist winners, Tyrannophorus Rex. Emily Sugars, I had to change it written down, I had to take the four out and replace it with the word four so I'd say it right. Emily Sugars, Max Harm, Simon Perry, Jason Hobbs, Paul Monaghan, and overall winners are Team Awesome Foursome, Christopher Caban, Wes Laws, Tim Plummer, Derek Cornelius and Kira Sifford. Team Boots and Cats, Sally Hearson, Laura Hampton, Johnny Francis, Dan Vanden Hender, Lucy Westgarth, James Wood and Matthew Wilson. Silver medalist, Team Almost Petite, Jill Judd, Alex Whitehead, Becky Stevens, Holly Blake, Donna Jenkins and Stephen Coxedge. And Oval Champions gold medal, nobody expects the worst.
First.
First. Ali Woodhouse, Sam Doughty, Seb Mulder, Sam Hayes, Roy Little, Craig Hicks and Helen Williams.
Spread out broken.
how you get medals. You bring beer. Bring team beer to the stage. Thank you very much. Nobody expects the worst. I'm almost done, so I can have it. Lastly, but not leastly, AAA class, bronze medalists, team Bodyfly Aero, Fiona Miller, Sam Lee, Giuseppe Damiano, Liz Moore, Guy Martin, Charlotte Pope. Silver medalists are team Final Vision, Matthew Wilson, Georgie Marsh, Stuart Murray, Lizzie Carroll, Laura Hamilton, and Wes Guest. And overall champions, gold medal, team Phoenix, Stephen Coxedge, Elise Sharp, Jack Bradford, Raphael Barbier Saint-Hilaire, and Jason Kelleher. Thanks as always to Trudy for helping put the list together. And that's it. Enjoy your day. Thanks. Thank you very much.